I decided to come to these workshops because, like, it helps me get, like, stay out of trouble and stuff. Like, helps me focus in class, good to experience. I've been getting A's since this program started.
My name is Dr. Elliot Gann. I'm founder and head of Today's Future Sound. Today's Future Sound is an organization that's based in the community. We do a lot of work in schools as well as community settings, and we use music production and media arts to teach, media literacy skills. We also use it as a therapeutic intervention to work within the schools, develop relationships with schools and with kids, and trying to help them learn about themselves, develop themselves, use it as a multimodal intervention. And, we're using music production and media arts as, you know, ways or vehicles to empower youth, both as community members, as artists, and also to foster their wellness as individuals as well.
My name is Sharon Thomas, and I'm a teacher at West Oakland Middle School, and I'm amazed at how my students are really taking to the Today's Future Sound program implemented in our school to help our students with beats, and they're allowing the students to use what they're learning in the classroom to incorporate into their beats. I've heard vocabulary and academic terms that they've learned in the classroom immediately put into raps that they assign to beats that they create themselves. And I've seen a major change in behavior and acceptance to learn in the classroom just because they know they'll go at some point during the week to do something with the beats.
So the beat making workshops, pretty much we come in, we give a brief introduction to the history of beat making and sampling. We may show a clip from a documentary or two, but really we like to jump right into it. It's very hands-on. Immediately getting the kids on the pads, on the beat machines, teaching them a little bit of music theory, but teaching them how to chop up samples, how to sample songs, how to create their own original songs using different hardware and software. They usually run from an hour to 2 hours, but we get them right away hands-on. That's really important. That's an essential part of our approach is the hands-on approach and engaging them in that way. And we have to try to rotate them through stations with different instructors. We also have a DJing component too. We try to, again, it's hands-on, using music they already know and like. I've certainly seen students develop through this process. I mean, there's one student in particular who was getting sent home every, multiple times a week, and now he is doing a lot better in school. He's performing better academically. He's not getting, sent home or suspended or that kind of thing. And we've tried to make this an incentive for him, but also to try to, give him positive role models, people to talk to that, he's comfortable talking to, and say, hey, what's going on, man? Like, why are you getting in trouble? And how can we help you? We want you to be here for the sessions. We don't want you missing, so you gotta stay out of trouble in order to do that. Just give them someone to talk to. I mean, that's really important. Have someone that you trust and you have a relationship with. And fundamentally, that's what it's all about. It's all about relationships. We're using the music making, the media arts, the beat making, DJing, all that to build relationships and to get in there and establish relationships and then roll with that. And then we can help.
Our organization serves the youth of Oakland by offering high-quality music and arts programming. In order to sustain this work, we need support from the community and funding to help grow a new generation of artists and engaged citizens. Thank you.